Rick Perry. So how did you think he did, David, yesterday?
I think Rick Perry did a great job of appealing to the average uninformed voter in the same way that George W. Bush appealed to the average uninformed voter.
Which is terrifying.
Which is terrifying. Yeah. It is completely scary to me that that's the appeal, because that actually, to me, says he could actually win, and he's nuts. He's completely nuts. I think maybe more so than George W.
Did
Bush.
Did you think he had a good debate politically? You thought, so you thought he looked sort of as the same as he had in the other two.
There was something different. I don't know exactly. I'm sure we'll figure out exactly what it was. I just think that it almost, his swagger and his style appeals to the same people that like George W. Bush, also for reasons that should have no place in a presidential election.
Yeah, that's a good point. I did think, I think the first half of the debate for Rick Perry was much better than the second half of last night's debate. I think that he really squandered any kind of currency that he gained in the first half of the debate. And again, I don't know who's watching these debates.
Well, he didn't, the sense was that he didn't, the sense among the Fox Insta poll, certainly, that he didn't win. The analysis from the Huffington Post was that he did better than the first two, but still didn't do great. But he was definitely better and more composed.
With different eyes than the people who actually are, you know, sitting there saying, oh man, am I going to vote for Bachman? Am I going to vote for Perry? You know, we're not the people who really are fit to judge, right?
But as I watch these debates, which goes back to what I said about Rick Santorum, when I watch these debates, like, I know how I'm going to feel about it, and I know how you guys are going to. I try to watch it like, does that connect with the guys who were cheering this stuff?
Right.
Just out of, but CBS in their analysis of it says he was caught flat-footed from the very beginning when asked about specific policies he would implement about the economy, didn't seem to have a response, and started speaking in generalities, which I think is fair. And again, so then he did try. Many people are framing it as the Romney Perry debate again, that they just went after each other, ignoring everyone else. So this moment, I thought, was really outstanding. It actually reads just as well as it sounds. But let's hear it, because this is Rick Perry letting Mitt Romney have it with a zinger that I think Romney's going to feel for quite some time.
I think Americans just don't know sometimes which Mitt Romney they're dealing with. Is it the Mitt Romney that was on the side of against the Second Amendment before he was for the Second Amendment? Was it before these social programs from the standpoint of he was for standing up for Roe versus Wade before he was against Roe versus Wade? He was for Race to the Top. He's for Obamacare, and now he's against it.
Ouch!
We'll wait until tomorrow and see which Mitt Romney we're really talking to tonight.
You know what's hilarious?
I mean, just like, do you really want to go to that State of the Union?
Romney starts actually writing down rebuttals. And then halfway through, when Rick Perry goes completely off the rails, you can see him visibly cross out the rebuttals. He doesn't need to do anything.
He's like, I'm good. I'm going to let this one stand.
I'll let him have this one, exactly.
That's great.
Yeah, Your Honor, And the defense? We have nothing further. We're good. I just, because Lucas went to the trouble. Let's just read through it real quick, because it's fun to read, too. I didn't know we'd actually have it. Is it the Mitt Romney that was on the side of against the Second Amendment before he was for the Second Amendment? Was he before the social programs from the standpoint of he was standing up for Roe versus Wade before he was against first Roe versus Wade? I mean, we'll wait until tomorrow to see which Mitt Romney we're really talking to tonight.
Well, you know how sick the situation is. People now will the Republicans, Republican base, Republican primary voters will hear people like us talking about it, and then it'll have the Sarah Palin effect with the Paul Revere thing. Oh, they're just going after her. They're putting her words up on the screen, and they're making her look bad, and it's all a setup.
No.
I'm going to support him even more because he's the victim of a liberal attack.